After a brain injury, one of the things that happens is people try to do the same amount of activity that they did prior to their injury. And the brain injury in and of itself often causes pretty severe issues with fatigue. So at Coastline, where I teach, we'll have students who will come in and our program is 4 hours a day. By the end of the first hour, they're pretty much wiped. So that idea of really trying to figure out what kinds of activities in your everyday life that impact your fatigue, I think is really important. And so the Best Sweet Pace My Day app allows them to enter in various and sundry tasks that they might do. It allows them to track the amount of time that they do that. And it sort of limits them. The way the app works is they really can't do an activity for more than an hour without the app stopping them and sort of requiring them to self-regulate, to monitor how they're doing. Should I keep doing this task? Or should I stop? Should I take a break? Oftentimes what happens is they just keep going. You know, they think that they need to read a textbook, and so they'll read it for 4 or 5 hours. Unfortunately, after the first 20 or 30 minutes, they often aren't really absorbing and comprehending. So the whole idea is to help them really focus on how long they can do a task successfully and to limit it to that amount of time before they take a break or they sort of reassess. They actually are able to identify how long they think they can do a task and still have energy. That's the most important thing. Never to wipe yourself out with any given task. So they identify that, then they start the task. The way that we've created it is we also have them rate several different scales. They can choose which scales they want. But there's a pain scale and a depression scale and an anger and frustration scale and a mood scale. And what they do is they identify their current level at the beginning of each task, and then they identify that same scale level at the end of the task. So an example might be, I have lower back issues, and I've realized that there's certain tasks that I do, that if I do it for a certain amount of time, the pain is almost always there. So by using the scales, it allows us to identify sort of which tasks are most taxing for us, and how they impact our physical being as well. And then at the end of the task, an alarm goes off, and it then has them rate that post scale. And then they can decide whether or not they want to take a break or whether they want to continue or whether they should just stop that task altogether for a while.
This video was produced by BrainLine, thanks to generous support from the Infinite Hero Foundation.